Welcome back to the crown of the old Iron King. Let's take another couple of cracks at the ninja dude. Okay, that's not actually his name, but that's what I'm gonna call him. I wonder if my streak of doing really, really well against bosses the first time I come back is going to continue. What rings do I have on? Should I put on my bracing ring? Yeah, I guess I will. It is a pretty long boss fight. I didn't even bait him out. How useless. Okay, stab him in the back like, oh god. Or get stabbed in the back. That's how true honorable soldiers fight. They wait until their enemies turn their backs and then they stab them. I'm waiting. Oh, shit. I didn't think the fireballs would come to the side that much. Do I need two or three? It's been so long since I've used these gems, I don't actually know how long they last. Oh, two's actually fine. Damn, wow. They heal for a really long time. Once again, we reach the question of, do I run or fight here? There's a lot of enemies. Dodge too late. Don't fall. Did you really just try to shoot me through the pillar? That's just sad. Okay. Alright, here we are with a nearly full durability weapon, all of my Estus full health. Let's go back to the Simpleton's Ring. A simple ring for simple people. Here we go. Never seen that attack before. That's new. Ooh, stunned him. Sweet. Only took like 10, like 50 freaking hits to be able to actually stun him. Oh shit. Oh, it's fine. So I guess poise is like something that builds up really over time. Holy crap, I just realized he's actually kind of close to dying. Let's not jinx it. I wasn't even paying attention to his health. That was a really fun fight. Just a very cool enemy to fight a sort of samurai-like person. Fine work, praise the sun, indeed. Praise the sun. Oh yeah. Yeah, just a really cool enemy. It's all about reflexes. It wasn't particularly difficult, it was moderately difficult. But it felt satisfying and fun to fight, and the environment is really incredible. Like, this is one of the coolest boss arenas. It's just so beautiful. The reflections of that vibrant sky outside. It's a beautiful place. I just realized there is no ceiling that I can see. Yeah, that was really cool. Whew. Alright, let's see what's around here. I can finally appreciate the architecture. I was trying to do that before, but Some asshole samurai kept stabbing me. Lovely pillars. Let's see what's in here. Regret. Beanpole? What? Can I sit? I can sit in it, can't I? Can't I? Smelter wedge. Oh, whoa, what's happening? Where am I going? Oh, I guess I left? Why did I get a smelter wedge? Are there any more shades of Nadalia left? So I've only got one wedge left, so I used them all up before. That's weird. Oh, very, very strange. The fact that I have another smelter wedge makes me think there's more to the DLC. But I did defeat three bosses, and I'm pretty sure that's all the DLC has. Got 11 fragments. How do you complete it? There's something more going on here. I am going to go do some research on Nadalia and see if I'm missing something. I'll be right back. Okay, I just looked up all the locations of the various Ashen Idols, and I think the one that I'm missing is behind this door. I wish I could describe where I am, but I don't know how to. It's here. If you recognize this place, then yes, it's here. I know, very helpful. You're welcome. Anyway, I'm pretty sure I have not been here. No, I haven't. Okay. Well, shit, this is gonna be fun. Is he gonna come out here? Please tell me he won't come out here. Okay, good. Right, so I need to destroy the idol before I should bother destroying him, right? How the fuck do I do that? The idol is behind one of the doors, by the way. This one, in fact. Quickly!
Quickly!
Thank God I'm immune while doing this. Alright, at least I have it. I have it. Which should give me a I can't even get out. Yeah, that just gave me the completed soul. You. Here we go. By the way, I think there's something in there, loot-wise. I think something mentioned a life ring plus 3. Which I don't believe I have. I think I have a life ring plus 1. Yeah. A plus 3 would be amazing. But I do now have the completed soul, which is what I wanted. Somewhere. There it is. Yep, so gonna go see what I can make with that, but before that, let's try to find what the hell is in here. Gotta defeat this big bastard first. Alright, come on. I'm not very good at fighting these dudes. Alright, I guess I'll get a couple cheap shots in since it doesn't want to turn around. I have no stamina. Oh wow. That actually wasn't too bad. Alright, let's see what's in here. Wow. I wonder if these were jail cells. Reminds me of that jail cell in the Eerie. In Game of Thrones / A Song of Ice and Fire. Depending on which one you want to go with. I did not mean to close that. I meant to read the message. Hidden path ahead. Bullshit. Bull fucking shit. There's nothing here. Happiness ahead. Yes, it's very happy. They seem very jolly. Broadsword plus 7. I can actually use that. Wow, it actually does 200 damage. Oh wait, yeah, it's plus 7, never mind. Well, in that case, it's not that much, but that's pretty good. Very low stat requirements, too. See what this thing looks like. That thing looks more like a dagger. That looks positively tiny compared to my halberd. Two-hand this thing. My foes will tremble in fear at the sight of my slightly larger than a dagger sword. Now this thing attacks pretty quickly. Very quickly. Try right. Oh, thank you for the tip. I never would have noticed this item here. Oh. They weren't kidding. There actually is something over here. Alright, so this is probably the life rain plus 3. Yeah, life ring plus 3. Alright, let's see how much health that actually gives me. So, currently I have 1884. From 1884 to... Whoa! Holy shit! From 1884 to 2167. That gave me like 300 health. I'm definitely wearing that. That is amazing. Although I really do like this simpleton's ring. I'm gonna say screw it to my life protection ring just for the sake of that life ring. That is beautiful. What are you doing, buddy? I think you're screwed there. Oh no, he's just gonna fall down to a nice little place. Okay, so now it's time to go see what I can make with those souls of those three bosses that I've defeated. So I'm gonna go find that, and I'll be right back. Okay, so from Ornifex, Weaponsmith Ornifex, Ornifex, rather, there are three things I can make from the souls. So the first one is the Fume Sword from the Fume Knight, which... appears to scale with mostly strength and a bit more dexterity, and also something else down there that I'm really not sure what the hell it is. The eye thing, I don't know, it's some sort of a magic thing, I think. It's a pretty standard, decently sized sword, and you can also make the Fume Ultra Greatsword, which is a little bit larger. From a straight sword to an ultra great sword, which requires 40 freaking strength and 30 dexterity. That is pretty insane. But look at the base damage. 300 is the base damage. It's not even upgraded. That's pretty awesome. And the last one... Actually, no, sorry, there's actually four things you can make. Yeah, sorry, there's four things. There's also the katana. That Alon, Alone, however you pronounce his name, that he was using against me. Which I'm actually very interested in using that. I'd have to redo my stats, which really isn't that big of a deal to get enough stats to do it, but it's a moderate strength and a high dexterity sword. The damage doesn't seem amazing, but just the idea of being a dexterity build with a katana is very alluring. It's very cool. And I believe the last one here is this. Yeah, it's the Chime of Screams. That sounds pleasant. It's from Nadalia. Obviously a magic weapon, so not exactly for me. Yeah, it's interesting. You actually only fight three bosses, but you actually get four souls because you get Nadalia, who you didn't really fight. Unless you consider all of your encounters with her ashen idols to be mini-encounters, I guess. You defeat the boss through defeating the fragments of the boss, I guess. Yes, I'm actually very interested in making this Bewitched Alon sword, and I think I will. But first, let's go see what else I can make, because I'm pretty sure there's another guy that can make some different stuff for me. So I'm going to go check that out, and I'll be right back. Alright, here's the last couple things I can make, thanks to Strayed of Olifus. There's two things here. One is the Smelter Sword. You know, didn't I fight another Smelter-type demon? In the Land of Fire? The Iron Keep? What was that thing called? Like, I wonder if this is actually the new one I fought, or the old one. Do they both have the same name? I'm honestly not quite sure. I'm just gonna assume this is new. So there's the Smelter Sword, which is a very high strength, but actually surprisingly low dexterity, ultra greatsword. And it does surprisingly little basic damage, but it does a bunch of fire damage as well. And apparently has a special attack of some sort. The earth spouted fire, and a beast arose from the flames. The short-sighted king was incinerated by the creature in one swing, and his castle devoured in a sea of flames. And the last thing is a spell that you can make with the soul of Nadalia, Outcry. Spouts multiple dark flames, and that's all it says about what it actually does. Not exactly not exactly a magic person, I am, so I don't really know how that works or how good it would be. It says it has one use, which doesn't seem like very many. It's also very expensive, 45,000 souls. Yes, 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 go screw yourself. Uh-huh. So I do actually want to make that katana. So let's go ahead and go make it. Thankfully, Ornifex is very close to this bonfire. Just a quick little romp through some spiders and huge sand thing that wants to swallow me whole. Is this the one? Yeah, this is the one. Alright, let's go ahead and make it. I just realized how much it makes sense that you can make two swords from the soul of the Fume Knight, because he had two swords, a huge sword and a smaller sword. That totally makes sense. Alright, let's make this thing.
Come back again if you find another soul.
There it is. Hold on, let me compare it to this. To my halberd. Obviously it does vastly less damage, but... oh yeah, it has a bleeding effect. That makes sense, because it did cause bleeding to me. Much less poise. What is this one? Counter strength. I don't counter enemies, do I? How? I'm not even sure what that is. It's also heavier. Which is kind of amazing. That's actually heavier than my halberd. But it's so thin. Anyway, let's give this thing a shot. Ooh, that is beautifully long. Let's compare its length to my katana. Alright, so that the tip of that pretty much comes right up to that jar. Let's see. Okay, it's actually almost as long as my halberd. And of course, that's pretty much the entire part sticking out of my hand as a blade. It doesn't really matter where you hit them. It's going to do full damage regardless, unlike my halberd where you have to hit them on the tip. Look at that beautiful sword. Cool animation set. Alright, so the strong attack is a very straight and strong slam. I want to make sure I don't hit Ornifex. Oh god, don't petrify myself. Yeah, this is a cool weapon. I'm not convinced about the damage, though. I mean, what does bleeding actually do? Doesn't it reduce stamina? Or does it actually cause damage over time? I thought it reduced stamina. If it does, then wouldn't that be entirely useless against enemies? Because enemies don't have stamina, do they? I don't know. Could be more of a PvP weapon, maybe? Looks cool, though. Alright, well, I do believe that is the end of the DLC. If I've missed anything significant, then let me know and I'll maybe check it out. But I think that's the end of the DLC. This was a damn fun one. Yeah, I really enjoyed it, and it seemed quite a bit lengthier than the last one, too. And the last one was already pretty lengthy. I've been very happy with the DLC so far. And there's still one more DLC to go. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll see you on the next DLC.